The French Riviera is the summer haven for the richest of the rich. Millionaires and billionaires go there to lazy in the sun, drink cocktails and shop. But hard on their Gucci heels is a gang of thieves the likes of which police admit they've never seen. They're called the Pink Panthers, and their jewels of choice are diamonds. So far, they've stolen nearly $500 million worth. And the cops chasing them have told Liz Hayes the Pink Panthers are about to strike again.
We are a little bit nervous because we want to arrest them and before they do the heist or before something bad can happen.
You know that they're planning a heist in the next few weeks, but you don't know where.
Exactly.
Wow.
Detective Jan Glassy has been hunting the Pink Panthers for more than 10 years. And this is what he's up against. How would you describe the Pink Panthers?
For me, perhaps the most organized teams in the world.
The most organized teams in the world?
The most organized team in the world, yes.
The Pink Panthers are jewellery thieves who carried out nearly 400 heists across a dozen countries. They strike with their trademark lightning speed and overwhelming force.
First, second, when they enter in the jewellery shop, is very confident, very violent.
Very intimidating.
They need to enter very quick in the jewelry shop and to take the control of the situation. And for that, they have 1-2 seconds maximum. In 1 second, you have gun in front of you. And after that, the action began with the rest of the group who enter in the jewelry shop and began to break the windows.
The Pink Panthers' tools of the trade range from hammers to speedboats and motorbikes. They target boutiques from Europe to Asia, leaving as quickly as they arrive.
They have 1 minute, maximum 2 minutes, to do the job in the jewelry shop. Maximum, it's 2 minutes. Normally, it's under 1 minute, under 60 seconds. And one guy is just there to check the time.
And they've probably got a very good watch to tell them the time.
Yeah, they have. That's the best watch of the world.
The Pink Panthers have always followed the money trail. Many members of the gang are former soldiers from Serbia and Montenegro who fought in the war in Bosnia. They're drawn by the lure of diamonds and watches, easy pickings in this part of the world.
Why diamonds?
Because the diamonds like the cash. It is very small. It costs a lot of money. You can travel very easily with a diamond and you can sell it very easily.
Hervé Conan is another detective who has dedicated more than a decade to chasing the Pink Panthers. Thieves, he says, who are expert in selling and even cleverly rebirthing their stolen diamonds.
How do I know if I'm wearing a stolen diamond?
It's difficult to know that your diamond is stolen or not. Very difficult. It is impossible.
And it's the same with watches.
Watches are like diamonds. You can sell it very easily and you can travel with your watch. One watch can cost 400,000 euros, so you can travel.
One watch can cost 400,000 euros?
Some watch can cost 1 million euros. So you can travel very easily with your watch.
That's like wearing $1 million around your wrist.
It is like having an apartment with you.
For high-end jewellery, those gems worth hundreds of thousands, even millions of dollars, there is no place in the world equal to Paris. And no surprise, a prime target for those thieves who dare. But the genteel upper-crust French have been no match for the military-trained Pink Panthers. Their brutally aggressive heists are done and dusted in a matter of seconds, often leaving their victims wondering what's just hit them.
Gee, not much stops them.
Yeah.
You have to kind of respect that, even if you don't like it.
As cops, we have always a kind of respect when we have an adversary who is smart. So I have to try to be smarter as them to arrest them.
Jan Glassy from the Swiss police and Hervé Conan, his French counterpart, are Europe's Starsky and Hutch. Two dedicated cops who've studied the gang's heists.
What places here has the Pink Panther hit?
What we know it is that Fred was attacked, Patek Philippe, and the Charles Boucheron.
This one here?
This one.
Despite the Pink Panthers netting nearly $500 million in gems and watches, the jewellers at the big end of town haven't been dissuaded.
So this is a very good system. We wait, and in that short period you can assess,
I guess. That's why
like Lorenz Borma, they've simply turned to even greater security, including airlock-style double doors.
You have to make our customers feel very comfortable when they come to see us, and at the same time we have to be very safe. So we try to do it in a way that's not so obvious.
Do you want to give me your hand?
Sure.
So you're married to the house now.
Wow.
You see, Lorenz Borma is a rising star in the very pricey, very sophisticated Place Vendôme in Paris, home to the most famous jewellers in the world. Lorenz designed Princess Charlene's tiara for her marriage to Prince Albert of Monaco and caters to the super wealthy.
So in your hand,
yeah, you have the
a couple
price
of hundred
of a
thousand
car.
Dollars. The price of a car.
Beautiful car, very special car. They're extraordinary pieces of jewellery, one of a kind.
To hold up places as public and as well guarded as these takes meticulous planning.
The robbery is quick, but the planning is not.
Yeah, we have seen that they can come a few weeks or few months before the robbery. They are planning, in fact, which jewelries are going to attack. They are planning how they will do it. So they have to work before commit the robbery. It is a job.
It is a job.
Is it a sort of job? Yes.
High-paying job.
Yeah.
The Pink Panthers often use attractive women to scout their targets in diamond heists as far afield as Athens, Dubai, even Tokyo.
The role of the woman was to get into the jewelry shop before the heist and to see exactly in which window there is what sort of stuff, how many people are working inside the jewelry shop.
The woman was usually a beautiful woman?
The women we know that have done this job were pretty nice women with very nice clothes, with very nice watches or jewelries. So they are like a very good client who's got money.
In Tokyo, pretty women were much more than scouts in what would be the greatest robbery in the history of Japan. The Pink Panthers stole the $40 million Comtesse de Vendôme necklace, studded with 116 diamonds.
We know that two women bring the diamonds from Japan to Europe by plane and carrying the diamond in a natural part of the woman when...
internally?
Yeah.
Carrying diamonds internally?
Exactly.
Gosh. I'm not sure that's an easy thing to do necessarily.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know.
Coming up, the heists just get bigger. Have you seen anything like that before?
It's one of the biggest.
From London to Saint-Tropez.
It's impossible to win.
But the law catches up with one Pink Panther.
Suddenly I see someone coming downstairs.
That's next on 60 Minutes. The Pink Panthers are the most notorious jewellery thieves in the world.
The most organised teams in the world.
They smash and grab from the most exclusive boutiques.
Very violent.
Very intimidating.
Normally it's under 1 minute, under 60 seconds.
Their loot, diamonds, watches, precious pieces worth nearly $500 million.
How do I know if I'm wearing a stolen diamond?
It's impossible.
And the cops who know them best warn Australia should not be complacent.
So we should not think that we're out of the picture.
No. No country who can say that. Every country can be touched by a heist made by Pink Panthers.
It was the robberies at the Graff jewellery store in London's posh New Bond Street which put the Pink Panthers on the map and gave them their name. The thieves took $80 million worth of jewellery.
So we meet again.
Just as in the Peter Sellers movie Return of the Pink Panther.
Because your thief is an Englishman.
How do you know that?
It is my business to know that.
Police eventually found one of the gems, a rare blue diamond, in a jar of face cream.
Yes, one and the same.
In recent years, the Pink Panther heists have become even more fearless. In the height of summer, amid the packed streets of Saint-Tropez, they struck a jewellery shop in the centre of town. Detective Jan Glassy says the Panthers simply blended into the crowd and pounced.
Think why it's a tourist who is coming to buy something, perhaps. And they open the door. And here we can see, well, typically, the first guy enter, threatens the people with the gun, and the rest of the team is on the job. Breaking the windows. And they are staying there maximum 1 minute.
For the locals, it was the heist of the century. It was audacious enough to steal $3 million worth of gems from the crowded heart of Saint-Tropez, but it was how they got away that was truly brazen. It took just a quick dash down here to a waiting speedboat, and they were gone.
Even for French detective Hervé Conan, the Pink Panther's ingenuity has to be admired.
And when they get into a speedboat and disappear?
It was a good idea. It was a very good idea.
There is a flamboyance about the Pink Panthers. They like to do things in style.
I think so. Yeah.
But then came the most daring heist of all. Dubai, 2007. The quiet of an exclusive shopping mall is broken by the squeal of tyres on marble.
Have you seen anything like that before?
No, like Dubai, it was really one of the biggest, very well organised.
I believe it was brilliant. The idea was brilliant.
We see here the first car entering, followed by the second one.
Reversing.
Very important because so they are not going to break the airbags. And after that, we are here, we can see it's very fast, the action, and they know exactly where they go. Every guy knows exactly what he has to do, and he knows exactly where to go in the shop and which windows where there is a presentation of jewels he's going to break.
They got away with $4 million in jewels and precious stones. And although a couple of the gang members were caught, the mastermind, Milan Lapoya, escaped. That is until an extraordinary chance encounter with Jan Glassy in a French hotel.
Suddenly I see someone coming downstairs. I say, oh, it's Lapoya. And we run outside the hotel to try to stop to catch Lapoya. And we fight, we...
So you ran after him?
We ran after him, trying to... But the problem in France, I have no gun, no handcuffs, because I am outside Switzerland.
After a long chase, Lapoya was eventually subdued.
When he stand up, there was a colleague with a dog, and he just looks at the guy and say, very good job. And there he was arrested.
But of all the Pink Panther heists, it was their robbery here in the heart of Monaco, previously regarded as the fortress of Europe, that galvanised authorities around the world.
They stay like around 2 minutes.
That's as long as it took?
2 minutes is very long when you have a gun in front of you.
For store manager Nathalie, it started out as just another day selling expensive jewellery to the wealthy. When the Pink Panthers struck, they were not in the least bit deterred by the presence of a customer and his young child.
That day, I have a customer who was sitting here, and he was supposed to be a customer, so I asked me for some watches. There is another guy ringing the door, so I opened, and he had a newspaper and just put the gun on the face of the baby.
So he had a gun hidden under a newspaper?
Yes, exactly. He said, braquage, braquage, with a East accent, and it means like hold up, hold up. I was very afraid because I was standing up here and I want to go in the corner with the man because, you know, we have nothing around you and you're more afraid, more frightened.
Nathalie is one of the lucky ones. Many victims have been so traumatized they've never gone back to work.
The Pink Panthers, they're a little romanticized, and there was a view that they were these Robin Hoods.
No, they are bad guys playing. And the money is 99% of the time is used for them, for their own pleasure. And they are not giving this for schools in Serbia, and that's bullshit. Mm.
That is bullshit.
Yeah.
There have been a number of arrests, but when Pink Panthers go to jail, they don't always stay there. Last year, the gang broke out one of its members from this jail in Orbe, Switzerland, smashing through a gate and firing machine guns at the guards.
Have you an authorization or...?
Today, the prison authorities are still jumpy.
Were you shocked at how bold they were in breaking out their colleagues?
No, because when a Pink is in jail, if he's member of a good team, it's normal that the guys are going to try to escape him.
As a policeman, though, I mean, as the man who's been on the tail of these Pink Panthers for 10 years, you must be so frustrated when they escape like that.
It's part of the game. That means it's part of the game. We can never win every time.
But detectives Glassy and Conan are now having to deal with another problem. A new generation of Pink Panthers and copycat thieves. This is vision of a recent jewellery heist in Paris by a copycat gang who hurled smoke grenades as they made their getaway.
It's impossible to win because when you're arresting a team, a new team is going to arrive after. And sometimes you're arresting people twice.
The Pink Panthers have gained international notoriety for their brazen heists. But in truth, they're thieves, whose crimes have devastated the lives of hundreds of victims. Robbers, who Hervé Conan and Jan Glassy are determined to catch.
For this guy, I want to make a lot of money, but I don't want to be arrested. And it's a game, it's a cat and mouse game with the cops.
You obviously love the chase.
Yeah, I love it.